I lived until I was 11. But it was just a fabulous place to be. It was a great place to grow up. My mum was a secretary. My dad worked in Peckham for a car dealership. Being the eldest is great until you realise that other children are going to come along. My brother was pretty cool. I didn't really notice him. He was just like my sort of henchman. But my sister came along, that was trouble. Because she was faster, better, brighter, and blonde. So, that was pretty tough. And to be honest, it remains pretty tough. We were just free. We just did what we wanted. It was really lovely. It was a happy time. Every time we were naughty, we were forced to take up another instrument. So I did flute and piano, and my brother did guitar and piano, and my sister did violin and piano. And after school, I would go and see this woman called Mrs. Green. So this is my piano teacher's house, but it's totally different. So I was about 6 or 7 when I first came here. You know, when I was little, it just felt like such an imposing place, this. I would wander down the pathway and I'd always feel the same thing, which was trepidation. Her fiancé had been killed in the war and she lived on her own. And she was so kind and sweet, but you felt very alone and rattling around that big place, you know. Just very quiet and sigh and I'd do my scales and the clock would tick and then I'd make a mess of the scales and she wouldn't really say very much, you know. And then I'd put my music in my satchel on the steps and then my mum would be waiting for me and I'd drive home. Why would this amazing experience have to be conducted in such a quiet, solitary way? And I think that's partly what killed it for me, really. I do feel very sad. One of my most favourite places in the entire world because it's a sort of oasis of calm in the middle of the city. I have a sort of quite a split personality in that one part of me wants total silence, but then the other half of me just is a clown. Good girls. The stuff I do on telly is quite mad, and then I come home and the door's shut and it's a little bit of music on in a bar. Music's a huge part of my life. It's how I become calm. I started playing piano when I was about 6, and I started because my mum told me I was going to start playing the piano. I love a drama bit. It's very special, I think. But sitting out at a piano, I just associate with being frightened. It's quite a two things, I think. Not feeling I really know what I'm doing, but also seeing what it's like when people do it properly and feeling I shouldn't be doing this because I'm no good. Basically what I'm saying is I'm a perfectionist. And the thing is, anything that I did when I was at school that I realised I couldn't do well, I just stopped doing. And I think that's something that sort of haunted me through my life, really. It stopped me doing so many things. I thought, well, I can't, I'm incapable, I'm stupid. And, you know, I had sort of enough wells of self-loathing to make most processes quite difficult, but particularly playing music.
After 25 years, Sue is about to face her fear by taking up the piano again. But that's not the only challenge that lies ahead. Mentored by an international virtuoso, she's going to be performing at a major classical music festival in just 4 months' time.
I want to sort of reclaim sitting at a piano and playing music from the clutches of being a sort of frightened kid doing dull scales. So I just don't think it has to be like that.
Welcome to Just a Minute.
I get very, very nervous about playing the piano because there are right notes and there are wrong notes. And in my performing career, there's no such thing as the wrong thing to say. I just don't get nervous.
And the subject is my favourite composer. 60 seconds starting now.
I am torn between Benjamin Britten, the great classical giant of the 20th century, and Mike Batt, composer of the Wombles theme tune. Remember, you're a Womble. I was a really, really shy child. I had this slight stammer. There was something about music which meant, you know, I had a relationship to something that was not awkward. Whereas outside of that, I felt that a lot of my life was awkward. I suppose the idea of music being a major communicating tool was taken over by poems and stories and all these things that I was asked to read as a way of improving my speech. And so suddenly, for me, I think imprinted in my head was the best way to communicate verbally.
And can there be anything more beautiful in the world than love?
Sue challenge.
Yes, there can.
What do you think it is, Sue?
Mindless sex.
When there's been no words, you have to resonate something more profound, and it has to come from a different part of you, and that's the part that's probably a bit scary to show, which is the sort of vulnerable part.
Work has dominated Sue's life since she and her comedy partner Mildred Roach went their separate ways.
We had a great love of each other's lives now and then, and it's all the more perfect because it's platonic. And it's very hard to go separate ways. It's also very hard when somebody goes off and has kids and has that life. It sort of points up, I think, that your life is different. That you're not homosexual, you're not going to have children, which is a choice I made. There were lots of very complicated sort of existential things to work through, I think, because you're trying to find out what you are as an individual. You know, I've always been a double act. And interesting, this prison in my life is probably the first time I've ever been on my own, actually.
En route to her next mentor session, 41-year-old Sue is suffering the same feelings of dread that she felt before her childhood piano lessons.
I've got about maybe 5 weeks, and I'm aware that I am severely coming up short. I'm not going to get this experience again. This is an amazing experience, so it's churlish not to go for it.
Well, this second session, I'd love to hear Sue just play the piece through.
So do you want to play it all the way through?
But would you like to?
I mean, I can't. I don't think I could. Do you want to?
Stress is coming up. I just don't get nervous for anything apart from playing the piano now. I just could vomit. But I don't think that's what Mason would have wanted. It's really hard. The first two bars are difficult, but then it all collapses on the third bar, so that's the point where I just panic.
All right. Take it.